What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. If you've watched any of our design pattern videos, you may recognize the restaurant or food delivery app example we gave several times. The application we mentioned allows you to order food online and eventually pay for the food you bought. But you see, the buying part wasn't actually targeted by any of our previous videos, and we never tried to implement it. So let's try to do that now. So suppose we have this payment service class where the amount we need to pay was already provided to us, and all we need to do now is implement this process order method, which will actually proceed with the payment and purchase. Okay, the payment is to be made using credit card, so the first thing we need to do is take the card details from the customer. Then we have to validate the information this user has provided. And finally, we have to actually proceed with the payment. However, problems may arise if you try to add to this currently working piece of code several payment methods, like PayPal, for example. In this case, you will need to wrap your current code with an if statement or switch case, and then introduce the new payment method alongside all its required working logic. Now, while this may seem an appropriate solution for the short term, it will be hard to maintain on the long run, especially if you decide to introduce even more payment methods. You see, what we just created is a block of code that is closed for extension and open for modification, because every time a change is required, we are going to have to open this method and modify it. And that is obviously not what is stated by the open-closed principle we all know. Additionally, this class handles several functionalities. So far in this example, it handles both payments by credit card and through PayPal. And that contradicts the single responsibility principle as well. So to fix this, what we need is kind of a strategy that places each payment method in its own class, making this class responsible for a particular payment method. And additionally, these classes we create should be easily interchangeable or replaceable by one another. One way to do this is to apply the strategy design pattern. The strategy pattern is a behavioral design pattern that lets you define a family of algorithms, put each of them into a separate class, and make their objects interchangeable. Let's try to apply it on the payment example we just saw. To do this, and as we just mentioned, we have to start by extracting each payment-specific logic to its own class. In our example, we are going to have the payment by credit card and the payment by PayPal classes. And to make these classes interchangeable, what we have to do is create a common interface for all of them to implement. You can also go one step further and extract the common behaviors into separate methods instead of dumping all the logic into a single one. So in this example, we can extract the collect payment details, the validate payment details, and the pay methods. This will grant us more flexibility later on while shaping the skeleton of the common algorithm all these strategies should make use of. These methods can now replace the piece of code we wrote at the beginning of our video in the payment service class, in which a strategy should be defined. You see, this class has no visibility anymore on how the payment is being conducted, and it shouldn't, because it is making use of the strategy interface. This way, we can add new algorithms or modify existing ones without changing the code of the service or other strategies. Now, if a client wants to make use of the code we wrote, all he has to do is define the strategy he wants to use and pass it to the service. Notice also how the strategy is now easily replaceable at runtime. Okay, I know most people confuse this pattern with the state one, and I'll get to the comparison in a bit. But before doing so, let's take a look at the structure or class diagram of the strategy pattern while relating it to the payment example we just implemented. The first thing you may notice is the context class, which was the payment service class in our previous example. The context maintains a reference to one of the concrete strategies and communicates with this object only via the strategy interface. Speaking of which, the strategy interface is common to all concrete strategies. It declares one or several methods that are used by the context to execute a strategy. The next classes in our diagram are the concrete strategies, which were represented by the payment by credit card and the payment by PayPal classes. These classes provide their own implementations for the strategy-specific methods. The context doesn't know what type of strategy it works with or how the algorithm is executed. Finally, the client should create a specific strategy object and pass it to the context, which must expose a setter for this strategy, allowing clients to replace the strategy associated with the context at runtime. Now, before ending the video, I want to tackle the difference between the strategy and the state patterns. You see, the state can be considered as an extension of strategy, as both patterns are based on composition. They change the behavior of the context by delegating some work to helper objects. However, strategies are completely independent and unaware of each other. But states can be dependent. You can easily jump from one state to another or depend on another state. All states can be aware of all other states. Additionally, the strategy pattern is really about having different implementations that accomplish the same thing. For example, you might have different sorting algorithms in a strategy pattern. And regardless of which algorithm you pick, the result of the sorting will always remain the same. Or in our previous case, regardless of which payment method you went with, the result will be the purchase of the items. But the state pattern is about doing different things based on the state, hence the result may vary. So instead of having inside your code several switch cases or if-else statements to account for each state, the state pattern will automatically call the correct behavior by making use of composition and polymorphism. Okay, to sum everything up, the strategy pattern lets you define a family of behaviors, put each of them into a separate class, and make their objects interchangeable. On top of reducing code duplication, by doing this, your several behaviors or strategies will be easily replaceable and interchangeable by clients at runtime. Additionally, by following the strategy pattern, you will be applying the single responsibility and the open-closed principles, because each strategy is isolated in a separate class, and you now have the ability to introduce new strategies without modifying the existing strategy classes nor the context. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.